are everything you're looking for in a sports car, plus you get two extra seats.
Which you need.
Which you do need. Never really been a big fan of Mazda, but that was until I actually drove the RX-8.
And of course, the biggest thing that makes this car unique is the rotary engine.
This is the Hyundai Genesis Coupe with a 3.8-liter engine. This car came out of nowhere, especially from Hyundai.
The Hyundai Genesis sedan and the Hyundai Genesis Coupe are nothing the same. They don't really share anything except this engine. It deserves its own name.
I really like how Hyundai has been steadily improving over the years.
Hyundai has become good enough. You don't have to make any excuses. You don't have to say, well, this is good for a Hyundai. They're now just making cars that are plain good.
If something Hyundai does is bad, well then that's not excusable, because they've made it clear to everybody they have come to play.
This is $13,000 cheaper than the Infiniti. You may think on the surface, wow, that's an incredibly affordable car, how did they make it that cheap? You get inside it and you go, oh, that's how.
I like the styling theme through the interior, but it's not exactly ergonomic. On the driver's door, the only way you're going to be able to get to the window switches is if you break your wrist.
None of the touch points in the car really are very nice, especially the steering wheel, which frankly has the hard plastic feel of an economy car.
Look at the shift lever, it looks like an upside down spoon.
This car has the automatic with the 6-speed paddle shift transmission. This is like the original first generation shiftable automatics.
Looking at the wheel, it looks like there's a nice, beautifully sculpted paddle shape waiting for you back there, when in reality they're little buttons behind the steering wheel and they don't even feel good in your fingers.
Shouldn't the paddle be the part that works instead of just a trail marker?
It's like Hyundai consulted Mattel when they were designing the whole interior. Right at the very top of the instrument stack, the most unnecessary gauge I've ever seen, torque.
That's a gimmick. It may as well be an iPhone app.
The seats in the Genesis Coupe look nice, but they're pretty thinly padded.
Everything about the materials and the interior on the Infiniti suggests it will be more comfortable. But for some reason, for me personally, I'm much more comfortable in the Genesis. Your money definitely went into the fun part of driving and not the luxurious part of driving. So what kind of driving do you do?
It's time for Hyundai to get that right. If they're bringing this car, if they're bringing it, they need to get that right. It's the Genesis Coupe that really defines where Hyundai is going, not only with their build quality, with their engines, and also their styling statement.
I really think the designer of the Genesis Coupe had a poster of the G37 sitting at his desk.
It probably did, but there's a lot of things about the styling that make it different and uniquely Hyundai.
To their credit, Hyundai's actually made a more attractive exterior. By making it more aggressive, it's actually more interesting.
My favorite things about the Hyundai are the concave surfaces from convex to concave right along the body side and how that flows into the trunk line.
I really like the Genesis styling, except I really wish the front end was different. I'd like the hood to just keep rolling down all the way to a wider mouth front fascia. Interrupting it with that little economy car grille just makes it feel cheap.
One of the most eye-catching things about the Genesis Coupe is the rear three-quarter window, how it kind of dog legs down. This car wouldn't be nearly as nice if it didn't have that.
They've actually made a car that looks good in every single color I've seen, and that includes not only bright red and bright blue, but yellow and green. I even like this car in gray, and that's a mirror, and no sports car should come in gray. Now, the minute that you're drifting around a corner at about 60 miles an hour, you don't notice any of that.
The thing about the Genesis Coupe is, the harder you drive this car, the better it gets. I think Todd is gonna really like this car because it's very visceral and it's pretty raw.
With traction control off, it feels organic. It feels like you're connected. And I'd much rather that than luxury any day. It's rewarding to really toss it through a corner and work hard on it. I've driven many more expensive cars with far less feel. It is truly fun to drive.
I like the immediacy of the Genesis Coupe. I like how everything is really light on its feet. The steering, the brakes, the throttle, everything is very crisp.
And there's no denying this has got grunt.
And I love the engine.
This engine has torque earlier than the Infiniti.
It really sounds fantastic.
Here's a Hyundai sports car with a better sounding V6 than the Nissan 370. I think the world's going to end. Now, if you bump up against the traction control, it comes down like a hammer. Thankfully, you can turn it completely off.
When you turn traction control off in the Genesis Coupe, it is off. There is no lingering or residual traction control at all. It's like a little fun button.
In many ways, Hyundai made the Genesis Coupe for me, which is weird because no one called me.
I need a sports car to be good at a lot of things. Just because it's got good handling and it's got a lot of power doesn't make it a great car.
So you're not buying the Genesis for refinement. You're buying it just for handling and fun. But frankly, isn't that the reason you buy a sports car in the first place? It was a great day, but I gotta say, they didn't go anything like I expected.
Well, it kinda did for me.
Subscribing costs nothing. Daily, not monthly, and our cars actually move. Fastlane Daily is fast and fresh, and here to stay.